Shall we close our eyes and pray? Lord Jesus, we come to the throne of grace and mercy, Lord Jesus. You speak, Lord Jesus. Oh, Father, send you forth your word and heal every broken heart, every broken bodies, broken homes. Be healed by your mighty delivering word, Lord Jesus. Send for your word, Lord Jesus. We want to hear from you, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Today, beloved, we shall meditate on a subject, how Jesus fulfills the desire of our heart. If we read in the Bible, when Jesus was in this world, we see many incidents that whoever came to Jesus with a desire, Jesus fulfilled the desire of that person. In Mark chapter 1, verse 40 to 42 says that a leper came to Jesus. Leper means the one whose flesh is rotting. His flesh is coming out. He's in terrible situation. And he was considered as untouchable during the days of Jesus. He came kneeling down, crying and weeping. Lord, if you are willing, you can make me clean. And Bible says Jesus Christ was moved with compassion. And he touched him. And his leprosy went away. New flesh came in his whole body and he was healed. Jesus fulfilled the desire of that leper. In Luke chapter 5, verse 1 to 5, there we see another wonderful incident. Two fishermen were whole night toiling hard, but they couldn't catch a single fish. And Jesus, while he was preaching, the crowd was overflowing. And Jesus requested and took Peter, Simon's boat, and he preached from there. And after preaching, Jesus Christ is the most grateful person in this world. Anything we do, any work for the kingdom of the Lord we do, any donation, any labor, any manual labor we do, Jesus notices it. And he's an unfailing rewarder of every good deed. Jesus Christ's heart was moved with love. Peter didn't ask anything. I have not caught any fish all night. He didn't open his mouth. But Jesus, through his powerful, revelation power, he knew that he had been unsuccessful. He knew the broken heart of his wife. His wife and children in their home must be waiting. When my papa will come, when my father will come, he will bring fishes and we will cook and then eat. But not a single fish was caught. And Jesus told the word of wisdom to Peter. Peter, launch into the deep. And Peter was astonished. He said, although I'm a fisherman, although I have tried to catch fish whole night, but I couldn't, but at thy word I will. And when he dropped the net, the whole net was filled with big fishes. And it was so much that he had to call another boat. And two boats, they filled with the fishes and they were about to sink. Jesus Christ fulfilled the desire of Peter. He wanted fish for his livelihood. His family must be waiting for the fishes to eat. Jesus Christ fulfilled the desire. Beloved, today evening, whatever desire you are having, just while we close in prayer, just tell your desire to Jesus. Same Jesus loves you. Same Jesus wants to fulfill all your desire. Bible says, if we read Proverbs chapter 10, verse 24, very beautiful and powerful verse it is. Proverbs chapter 10, verse 24. It says, the fear of the wicked will come upon him, and the desire of the righteous will be granted. What a sweet promise, beloved. The desire of the righteous will be granted. The desire of the righteous. You have been made. Every one of you have been made. If you have accepted Jesus in your heart, saying, Jesus, come in my heart. Wash me with your blood. Make me clean. Make me holy. Jesus comes and makes you righteous, and he has promised the desire of the righteous will be granted. Psalms 145 verse 19. Another beautiful verse says, Psalms 145 verse 19. There it is written, oh, he will fulfill the desire of those who fear him. He will also hear their cry and save them. He will fulfill the desire of those who fear him. Yes, beloved, our Lord desires to fulfill whatever desires we have. Psalms 37, if we read, oh, verse 4 says, delight yourself in the Lord and he shall give you the desire of your heart. Psalms 37, verse 4, delight yourself in the Lord and he shall give you the desire of your heart. If our desires are not fulfilled, our hearts become, oh, sad. Our hearts become broken. And that's why Proverbs chapter 13 verse 12 says, what happens when desire, Proverbs chapter 13 verse 12 says, hope deferred makes the heart sick, but when the desire comes, it is a tree of life. And Proverbs same chapter 13 verse 19 says, a desire accomplished is sweet to the soul, but it is an abomination to fools to depart from the evil. A desire accomplished is sweet to the soul. Jesus knows, beloved, when your desire is accomplished, it will be sweet to the soul. You will rejoice. Your heart will be filled with sweetness. Praises to the Lord. Praises to the, oh, sweet Jesus, wonderful Jesus. That's why Proverbs, what kind of desire we will have, beloved, if we have given our heart to the Lord. Proverbs chapter 11 verse 23 says, the desire of the righteous is only good. The desire of the righteous is only good, but the expectation of wicked is wrath. A few days before, beloved, as I was sitting in the presence of the Lord revealed a very beautiful thing in the life of Moses, which I believe that it will bless your heart also. When Moses was born, it was a very difficult, adverse time, hard situation. The king had passed a rule that every male Israelite boy has to be killed. Has to be killed. And when Moses was born, he was to be killed. But his mother, father, with great love, they hid him. For 3 months they hid him. And it would have been very difficult time. Small Moses, baby boy, must be in the night times, in the daytime, making noises, crying. Because he was a baby boy. And the Egyptian soldiers must be patrolling on the streets. Oh, wanting to catch some newborn baby boy, Israelites baby boy, to kill them. But with great difficulty, they hid it for him for 3 months. His mother, father might be lamenting, oh, in what adverse circumstances we have come. What hard time we have come. This law is passed and we have to kill. We don't want to kill our baby boy. And they hid him, but they couldn't after that hid. So one day, his mother with a heavy heart, she brought Moses and just kept in a basket and left in the river Nile. And that river was very big, very big. She didn't know, while she was watching the basket going, she might have realized some crocodile will come, some fishes will come, or he may get drowned. Oh, I'm seeing my little boy Moses. Oh, last time, she must be lamenting, she must be crying without any hope. But Bible says the steps of a righteous man are ordered by the Lord. Psalms 37 verse 23 says, the steps of a righteous man are ordered by the Lord. And he was ordering the step. The Lord Jesus is in control, beloved. The Lord Jesus is in control. He made the Pharaoh daughter, the princess, to come at that same time to take bath in the river Nile. And he made the little baby Moses basket to flow to that direction. The river was very big and wide, but Jesus made it because his word he has written. Proverbs chapter 21 verse 1. The king's heart is in the hand of the Lord. As the rivers of water he can turn, whichsoever he will. Because he's the maker of every river, every hill, every mountain. He's the creator. He made the baby Moses basket to flow where the princess was bathing. And princess' heart was filled with pity, with love, and she called her maids, bring that basket. What is that inside? When she opened, she saw little baby Moses crying, and she was moved with compassion. And she realized, he's a Hebrew baby boy. And she told, I want to adopt him. Bring her a maid who will take care of her. And Moses' sister was seeing that, and she immediately went to his mother and called his mother. And what a privilege. In Exodus chapter 2 verse 9 says, the Pharaoh daughter said to her, take this child away and nurse him for me. I will give you your wages. So the woman took the child and nursed him. Moses was nursed by his own mother. What a wonderful miracle it is. Jesus Christ is in control. And beloved, it is written, the Pharaoh daughter said that I will give your wages. Beloved, nobody, no mother in this world will ever get a wage for keeping or nursing her own child. But Moses' mother, he was born in adversity. His mother was lamenting, crying. Oh, what time my son has been born. We have to kill him. But the Lord gave him a life. And Moses' mother received the king's wages. The king's wages to nurse her own child. What a miracle. What a wonder. Beloved brother, beloved sister, tonight also Jesus Christ is moved with compassion. Whatever desire, whatever impossibilities, whatever difficulties, you must be crying and lamenting. Lord, I am in a hard situation. I am in adversity. There is no hope. There is no future. Death is about to kill me. You might be crying and lamenting, but know this, Jesus Christ is in control. He can turn every sorrow into joy, every impossibility into possibility. Then I was reminded of that wonderful verse that says in Isaiah chapter 61 verse 6. Beautiful verse it is written. Wonderful verse. Isaiah chapter 61 verse 6. Second part says, you shall eat the riches of the Gentiles, and in their glory you shall boast. You shall eat the riches of the Gentiles. Moses' mother was nursing her own child, but during that time she was receiving the king's wages. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. It's by the wonderful power of Jesus. Isaiah chapter 6.